I like to torture my body. So I just have to get pneumonia somewhere down the line with all the chest congestion and asthma. We got fog? What's fog? Where?
Where is it?
Oh, Portland? Okay.
I was like, turn it black.
You give Earl his $8,000 treat that I worked so hard for. I didn't even see it come in. Did you? 1 second. Oh yeah, 19 minutes ago. I didn't even see that. Yeah, I'll give it to him in a second. Days of rain, and now 2 days fog. We had like Thursday. It just poured rain. Friday, it was absolutely spectacular here. Today, it clouded over and was just nasty outside. Just nasty outside. And then, I can't hear what we're saying. And then it clouded over and it got like cold here today, and like they're expecting a lot of rain. A lot of rain coming up. Rain today, and the prediction was 5%. Yeah, it was like 40% chance of rain today. No rain. No rain.
Can you pass me a little bowl?
A little bowl of what?
Just an empty bowl.
Watch
Grey's Anatomy.
Thank you. What was I doing? I had a reason. Oh, Earl's treat. There we go. I got distracted. Again, see? I'm horrible.
No, you get distracted? Never.
Earl. You see, all of British Columbia banned rat poison today.
I know, it's so stupid.
To save the owls. Any riots tonight? Oh yeah, there was. Yeah. To save the owls, they banned rat poison.
Are they really killing them?
Yeah. Because the rats eat the poison, the owls eat the rats, and it kills the owls. You could barely hear it though while I was in the other room, yeah, but like you could hear him going off. Who puts poison outside? I'm just saying rat poison. We banned it. How do owls get to it? Rat poison got banned in British Columbia today because the rats eat the poison, the owls eat the rats, and the poison kills the owl. We have mouse poison here. We have mouse poison here as well. I'm finally sending something to your P.O. box. However, its estimated delivery is November 22nd to December 13th. It's all good, Luke. If you were using Amazon, just saying this. Rodent plague incoming? Oh, totally. If you're using Amazon to send it... I am, FYI. Okay. Switch from your Australian browser to the Canadian browser and send it through the Canadian browser. That way it shows up a lot quicker because it's going to... Oh, you did? You really? Wow. Okay. Interesting. Okay. I just figured that's why. That's normally what I do, and then it's like, you know, 2 day right away. But hey, there's stuff at my P.O. box that I haven't gotten. It's been there for a couple of weeks. It was all from Sezzit. And supposedly Flukey's Earl has been on duty. Yeah, Earl, there's already been a plague in his apartment. Yeah, Earl has killed 2 mice. Like, he's a vicious beast. That cat. Little vicious beast. I bet you Luke sent me a bar stool. How crazy that would be. But it's like times like these that I just like sit. But I do have parsnip over here. I have whatever this is. I don't know if you'll care for it too much, but I thought I always wanted to send something, but never knew what to send. Dude, I'll like it no matter what. A lot of people are sending Wyatt, like, books and toys now, and just, like, random stuff to it. So it's, like, pretty much, like, everybody's just sending Wyatt stuff because, you know, kids are easy to please. You know what I mean? Earl is, like, summer, constantly lurking, waiting to pounce. Don't quote that. Will somebody please quote that? Where's Flukey when you need him? Somebody needs to quote that. I wish I could remember too. I'll just add it. Where is my bot? There it is. Quotes. You used to be able to add it so it actually timestamped quotes and everything too. Literally, It used to, like, the API is broken now with Twitch and the bots, where it used to actually take what category you were in and timestamp it on the quote of, like, who said it, when they said it, what category you were in. And now their API is so broken. That's hard to do. I think you just do quote, not even random. Oh no, there you go. Back in the day, when their API would literally go like, how it goes like, quoted, triad, food and drink, on that date. Yes, yes. Get that text off the screen. Nice. What's up, cooking class poor? Stock looks good, chef. How's the night? It's going okay. It's going okay. So far, just hanging out, making some chicken broth to turn into chicken and dumplings now after this instead of chicken noodle soup. Although chicken noodle soup does kind of sound good also right now. But dumplings also. Dumplings. I think the dumpling is the way to go. Quote random. Clit tickler. Sammy. Food and drink. 2019. Dumplings are better? Yeah, we'll do dumplings. It's a chill night. It's Saturday. It's my Friday. I feel like garbage. For 2 weeks now, and I'm working on like my fine dining dinner that I've been trying to have since what, Thursday? I've been trying to do a fine dining dinner since Thursday, and I'm gonna do it tomorrow, everybody. I promise you, tomorrow. I'm working on some parsnip right there. We have our beets, we got the burrata. We got the chanterelles with the squash roasted off. We're gonna do this. You guys are gonna love the pasta dish that I'm gonna make. You guys are gonna be in awe of it. The pasta dish is gonna be crazy. But it's gonna be fun. Are the mushrooms still going to be okay? Didn't you open them already? Mushrooms are fine. They're just sitting in a towel, right?
In the bottom of my fridge.
So, since we cleaned them, like, they're totally fine. Did you cook them? Nope. We haven't cooked them, we just cleaned them and then put towels around them to take away any moisture. We got our beets, we got our pasta filling, we got things are looking good. We might actually save some of this stock. We'll take some of this like broth and set it aside also. And that way we'll like be able to glaze our pasta properly and everything. It'll be good. Really good. Yeah. About 2 hours in for this. Not bad. Not bad at all. Shroomies. Chicken thighs. Broth. Strain this thing of beauty off. Looks like immersion blender time for a bad little broth for 2 hours. Not bad at all. Yep, some butter. My sister and her family are supposed to be coming out here in a few weeks. I'm freaking stoked. It's gonna be amazing. Any plans, like, set in stone yet? Are they coming out for, what's it called? Are they coming out for Thanksgiving, or is it, like, before Thanksgiving? Are they just getting away from Indiana, Erie, Indiana, where they trick-or-treat on a Friday or Saturday night, no matter what day Halloween actually lies on? Like, we just need to get out of here. These nutballs trick-or-treating on Saturday night. Halloween's on Monday! Monday! I'll be here the week before Thanksgiving. No solid plans yet. They're driving it so they can take my sister's motorcycle back with them. Oh, snap. Says, keep it in your pants. She's married. Motorcycles are cool. I just want to be friends with everyone. I'm joking. Obviously, you don't have any pants on right now, right? Yeah, she has a little Yamaha. It's on off-road, but also street legal. Can go up to 60 miles an hour. But she likes it a lot. That's all that matters. Oh, and in Indiana, it'll definitely get a lot of good use out there if it's off-road. Moto bike, right? Honestly, the coolest person I know, and also probably the smartest. Feels bad, man. I was just told I was stupid. new lover. She's all sciencey, like you. I'm sciencey. I just do random fucking facts. Guys, like that I'm cooking with a paring knife tonight? Fuck it, why not? I wish I had a clip when you were talking about black holes. You were like, giggity. I don't remember anything about black holes. What black holes? The only black holes I know are your bum hole. I mean... what about black holes? It was a while ago before TwitchCon. I wouldn't know. Lungfish can go up to 5 years without water in a hard shell cocoon made of mucus. That's crazy. I didn't realize how much junk I have until I started packing, but as soon as I packed a few things, I shortly after needed some of the things. I can't win. What you gotta do is you gotta like make a list of essentials and then non-essentials. You pack all your non-essentials, and if like you need them, it's just like, ah, later, doesn't matter. But you always keep your essentials. The things you need. The things you need.
Is what you need.
What's up, Babs? Who won the baseball game tonight? Houston tonight, series 1-1. So what you're saying is Houston has a chance. It's all good. Phillies took an away game from them.
True.
What's up, Fluky? Black old sun, won't you come? And wash away our rain, black old sun. Won't you come? Won't you come? I'm pumped about this. I love chicken and dumplings.
Dumplings are good. Dumplings are really good. I just have no white wine right now.
I heard about Nancy Pelosi's husband. What? You're gonna eat Wyatt's candy? Wow, Holly. Wow. Gonna eat Wyatt's candy. Can you guys believe that? No, I didn't hear what happened. Break in, and then he got hit over the head with a hammer. Dude broke into her house with a hammer and attacked husband while looking for Nancy. Mm-hmm. Robin knows more about American politics than I do. And I don't even watch the news. 150 people killed, a mob fleeing violence. It was a Halloween thing, and it was just that they all got trampled each other. We get the thickened stuff now. Thicken this bitch. I'm not even getting into this because I'm just like, I don't want to talk about this. Let's take a Saturday night and make it really depressing, everybody. When we're already all depressed. It's like winter time. It's getting darker earlier. But on a brighter note, Elon Musk bought Twitter. Until I changed a filter on Twitter, and it's much better now. But the Canucks won a game, eh? Is that two now? Yeah, two. The Lions are 1-5. The Lions will be 1-5 for a long time. They ain't the team they used to be. Fly balls for what? What the hell you need a fly ball for? I need Babs to start catching fly balls. Is Babs a baseball player? Well, no, because they're going to be playing more games. So they'll be 1-6, 1-7, 1-8. Yeah, the only thing that matters is the one. It should be a zero. Didn't they beat, like, Arizona? Robin, tell Chad about how you broke the CC machine at the bar. CC machine at the bar? Oh, I have no idea how I broke it. I just did. Right. Oh, you're talking about like the debit machine. I don't know. I just did. The bartender was so angry with me too, and I'm like, I didn't even break it though. I think I was being a jerk to him also. And I don't know why, but I was. I think, what did I do? What did you do to it to break it? I tried to give him a good tip, and I messed up, and I tried to go back, something like that. I tried to give him a good tip, and I messed up, so I tried to go back to fix the tip, and, like, the machine froze, and then I was like, it's not working, like, I'm sorry, and the guy got all, like, pissy at me about, like, the machine freezing or whatnot, and I was like, oh, fuck you, like, you're a piece of shit, like, and then I don't even think I tipped him after he gave me attitude, like, come on, man, like, you're pouring me a fucking, like, vodka soda, something like that. You're a dude. You were a girl. He wouldn't have cared. Such a, I don't know. Fluky was the sober one, so he can tell the story. You hear about that dude that left a $1,000 tip to a waiter, but the credit card machine couldn't process a tip that big? No, I didn't hear about that. But Fluky, I do remember the guy was being an asshole. He was. Robin said, watch this, and proceeded to black out the entire signature pad. Oh, right, yeah, okay, I remember that. It still should have taken my signature, though. Should have processed it. Not my fault they have shitty terminals. I remember that. Okay, now I remember that. And the bartender was pissed. Fuck that guy. I spent enough money in that bar and tipped very well while I was there. You can't be pissed at that. The bartenders there were all dudes, and I feel like none of them were nice to me. That's how you know you're ugly. No. It wasn't even that, Libby. Like, all of them, no matter what, were, like, I think they were just told to be assholes. Like, I literally think they were told to be assholes. None of them cared. They were just there to, like, pour you a drink, take your tip, and, like, move on to the next person. But that said, that bar was packed full and very busy. So, but I also think the dude was a total fuck about it. I do think it was also that, like, we got the guy that was the short little man syndrome. You know what I mean? And so he was like, like, automatically, like, little man. Like, I think he was, like, up to here on me. So he totally, like, little man syndrome. Like, behind the bar, can barely, like, reach across the bar. Can't get the top shelf bottles because he's too short. Not gonna make any money if you can't reach the good liquor. Should have brought my step stool for him. Just, it's hilarious. That's all. Robin apologized twice and the dude just didn't say anything and continued to act pissed. And it's like, how the fuck am I supposed to know your shitty machines are gonna freeze? Like, what if that was my signature? I gotta say, in the States, the fact that, like, you tap and it still needs a signature is, like, just totally dumb. It makes no sense. Like, here in Canada, you can either tap to a certain amount of money, and it's, like, no problem. Or when you insert your card chip-wise, you put in your PIN, and it's all good to go. You don't need to sign anything anymore. It's just, you know, so much easier. Yet, for some strange reason, you guys need to sign still. So dumb. Like, a step that just doesn't need to be there. Like, anybody can forge a signature, and especially on those, like, dumb pads. Like, you sign on the machine, it's never your, like, actual signature. It's just stupid. Must be something with that bar. No, a lot of places in California made me sign. Usually when I tap, I don't have to sign. Must be a bar thing or a California thing. Yeah, it's probably just like a California thing. But it was like a lot of places in California made me have to sign. Maybe it's because it was a Canadian credit card. Maybe. I don't know. I signed at the bar too. Tried to use cash mostly though. I just do it because, like, while I'm there, everything goes on card so that one, I can see like where my purchases are, and two, I'm like insured, right? Like all of my purchases, my credit card, if I lose it and it gets used, it's all like insured. So that's why I would. When you travel abroad, you don't carry a bunch of cash on you. Even though it's like, I'm not traveling like really that far abroad, but still, you lose your wallet with like $200 in it on a night, like, you're screwed, because then it's like your credit cards and money, where everything just goes on card. It's so much easier to not worry about, right? I can say this, I was pooping during the convo, but signatures for cards are so dumb. 99.9% of merchants, people don't check that shit. I can literally say all of my credit cards don't have a signature on the back of them. They just don't. One, if I have signed the back of the card, it's worn off over time, so it's not there anymore. And it's not like you can, like, sign the back of it constantly. But, yeah. I had a friend who signed his name Lady Gaga for years, and the bank eventually called him in and had to verify that he was signing for purchases. That's hilarious. So somebody is actually checking then, eh? Crazy. Crazy. My credit cards, since they no longer require a signature, like Yeah, no, at this bar you had to sign with your credit card. It was the dumbest thing ever. I worked at a bank and I never signed my cards. Not once. Portland, like, government liquor stores? Or is it all privatized? Park could have received a lot of chargebacks, and their process requires signatures now. It's a good pro. Yeah, maybe. Maybe. Whether they ask or not, if they do ask, the business has the right to deny service until you sign the paper. And or back of your card. If you don't do that, which I don't, just get inside what they accept or not. True, true. If you have debit with them, they have to accept cash. Maybe they do it for personal entertainment. They like to see the progress of signatures to alcohol intake. I doubt it. All those bartenders are pretty fucking douchebaggy. I think that they were all douchebags because they work at like a gaming bar. And like, put it this way. They work at a gaming bar, and gaming bars attract just guys normally. Right? Flour and heavy cream? Coffee cream. And so the bar is practically like male oriented, and so on like a Friday, Saturday night, they're just getting like fucked over by guys every single time. Half and half? Who has that? It's supposed to be milk, but we have half and half that I need to use up, so I'm going to. Just a richer fucking dumpling. quote one. Hit that sub button. I don't know, Puerto Rico was the coffee capital of the world. Are you serious? I did not know that either. I would have thought somewhere in Colombia or Italy. What's up, Popa? Long time no see, dude. Don't the Finns drink the most coffee per capita? Maybe. I just know Italians love their coffee, but they don't drink a lot of it, right? Because they're all like espresso fiends. One cappuccino in the morning, and after lunch, one shot of espresso. After dinner, one shot of espresso. Washington drinks more. Did you know Vancouver actually drinks more coffee than Seattle? Did you know Vancouver actually has more Starbucks than Seattle? Let that sink in, motherfuckers. Actually say Vancouver drinks a lot of fucking coffee. Well, look at those dumplings. And diamonds are everywhere. My girlfriend drinks $20 of Starbucks a day. Well, that's just a waste of money. I drink about 40 ounces of coffee a day. I love it. How many avocado toasts around here? I don't eat avocado on toast. Not my thing. This person's gonna just kill it. Yeah. Go. Where am I going? Oh, I have to kill this. She spoiled. So much money going down the drain. It's just such a pain. I feel it every day.
It makes me go insane.
Sorry, I'm Loopy from Halloween makeup. So Robin Holy Diver went out for Aussie Halloween, but he's like 50 now. When they asked him at like midnight where to go next, all he could say was home. That's hilarious. Looks like a fun time with Chicken Box. Here is Total Blotto. I love it. Are you bumping the music? I am. I love this guy's voice. This guy is like TikTok. He got famous on TikTok, got signed to a record deal, and he like is a rapper ukulele player. Yeah. A rapper ukulele player. I find it so unfair. what does that mean? He's single. I'm single right now. Nobody here in the room with me. What does that mean? Daph being weird lately. Feels weird, man. I think he's trying to get Libby hooked up with somebody that she's never met before. Put in a word for who? Robin? Yeah, of course, me. I have many stories about Chicken Box and Max. Remember, what was her name? Vivian? Was it Vivian? Who used to stream on Twitch? Y'all remember that? Vivi? That chicken would fly on. Full on fly her out. Yeah. Vivi was a hot mess, and now she's not. She's in Germany now. And works for ESL, actually. She was high, Babs. Maybe fun, but smart. Oh, yeah. Totally did, Max. He won't admit it. If she did, he would totally admit it. I think she borderline abused him. In what way? In the bed? Or took advantage of, like, staying at his house for a while? She's half his age? Easily. Easily. I don't know. I don't think they messed around, but even if so, who cares? Yeah, I don't really care. I just like watching like her and she works for like ESL, the esports organization that puts on like Counter-Strike tournaments and Dota and all that kind of stuff. League of Legends, all that. Which is pretty sick. dude, Kayvon, Katvon, a mod there, says there was zero doubt they bang. Oh, it's just something we hold over him. Okay, pick a number. 1 to 6. 6. No big deal. I mean, maybe because the industry of people I hung around when I was younger were banging someone for the hell of it. Oh well, just a quick bang. Right? Earl!
I honestly have no idea where his catnip is. I have no idea where his catnip is.
You choose what deck I'm playing with, solitaire. His little white paws, he's like walking in snow, so cute. Hit the little tuxedo. What's this? Earl? Earl? What's this? Thank you. Oh, baby. This is dangerous. So many streaming parties, club events, etc. now doing and doing good. Kind of took advantage of from the up close and personal. Oh, sorry, here, I missed that one. Man, I swear, if I knew about Twitch and the direction it was going 5 years ago, when I DJ'd, managed clubs, would have had a hit channel on Twitch. I missed out. It is what it is, right? Woulda, coulda, shoulda. Sometimes, yeah, reflection is, like, all good and great, but, you know, dwelling on the past instead of thinking of the future. It's gonna stop you right there, right? Yep, I'm not dwelling. I'm just flipping through stuff and being like, could have been. Yeah, I guess it's dwelling. Oh, fuck. I guess. I just think it's amazing the amount of freaking people dressed up in costumes right now. I'm just like, this time of the year, I'm just like, yeah, no, not dressing up. I'm naked. I skipped the costume. If only Twitch would allow us. I'd be half naked right now. Let's go. Thank you. MG42s. These are the best. These kind of scenes. My favorite mini-series, Band of Brothers, of all time. I love this mini-series. Catan. Kenny, what's up? Long time no see. How's it going? Lost my first game. I play until I win. You will win. Look at this. Look at this right here. Oh, baby. Throwing peas in here. Got some chicken thighs, thinking of making a tiki. Nice. Tikka. Tikka masala. You win 2 to 3 games. Looks delicious. If only I had peas, or I mean, if only Fluky was here. If Fluky was here, he'd probably tell you how dumb I am and just shuffle playing cards until my hands hurt. Oh, are you actually, you're not playing on computer? You actually have a deck in front of you. The 1 to 6. You have like 6 decks of cards just lying around your house? I bought a deck and Fluky taught me how to play a new game when I was wasted. Was it called Royalty? Chicken and dumplings.
Yeah.
It'll have beans. He also did a magic trick, and he showed me how to do it, but I don't remember at all. I love magic tricks. That's how it goes. Officially, it's official. I'm making chili tomorrow. With beans. It'll have beans. So, it's already a pass. It'll be special. This is so good. Yep. No, we'll go to Hitch. He's in Japan right now. I would have, but we already, like, had somebody. I hate going back on stuff. Oh. Anyways. Actually, you know what? I'm actually cheating on him with you, Robin Loud. I checked today. I've been following him for almost 2 years. Oh, crap. I'm the other man. Robin, I don't raid. I actually decided I'm not going to raid tonight. I don't want to talk. What's up, Tipsy? Love the shirt. Thank you, Kenny. Thank you. Yep, you're the side piece. Yep, this is good. It's just amazing. Anyways, everybody, you should play the You're Not My Supervisor playlist. It's so Libby. All right, let's check it out. The ending is the best. Will you choke me a little bit?
Thank you. changed it again.
That wasn't so hard, was it?
That's what I said.
Answer me.
No, it's been too much. Ow! I have a girl a drink first. Jesus. You got another one in ya? Oh, we're not gonna play poker. I thought this was Ouija. That's what I love about this job. You learn something new every performance.
That's the best. Yes, well, now. To be fair, that's exactly how I'd respond if someone said they loved me. Peace the fuck out. Thanks for all our bits tonight.